Hello everyone and assalamualaikum. I hope you're all doing well. My name is Erwin Glenn Sipatatag and I'm excited to be here today to present to you. In this video, I will be discussing the topic talk about the cold water supply in buildings. I hope you find this presentation informative and engaging. If you have a questions or comments, please feel free to share them. Thank you for joining me and let's get started. So, first in chapter 13, subtopic is talk about water. Water is combination of two chemical elements called hydrogen and oxygen. It appears it is natural state as liquid, solid, or gas. Water in as liquid form is 830 times heavier than air. Hot, it is gaseous state or in form of vapor, it is 133 times lighter than air. Water is a liquid from weights approximately 307 gram US gallon and 1000 kilogram per cubic meter. Water is essential for the survival of the living organism and plays a crucial role in various aspects of society, including agriculture, industry, and daily life. The next is the three sources of water are rain. First is rain water. What is rain water? To the precipitation that falls from the atmosphere in the form of droplets. It is a valuable natural resource that can be collected and used for various purposes, such as irrigation, household chores, and representing groundwater sources. Second is natural surface water from the stream and rivers. Refers to the water bodies that are located on the surface of the land, such as lakes, rivers, and wetlands. These water sources are replenished by precipitations and play a vital role in providing fresh water for various purposes, including drinking water, irrigations, industrial uses, and supporting ecosystem. Next in the last is underground water. Refers to the water that is found beneath the earth's surface, typically in aquifers or other underground formations. It is an important source of fresh water for drinking, agriculture, and industrial purposes, and plays a crucial role in maintaining the earth's water cycle. Next is the impurities in water. Subtopic. Pure or uncontaminated water is not found in a near water in the form of rain, absorbed dust and gases of carbon dioxide and oxygen. Similarly, water in the grounds is exposed to pollution of organic matter, including animal and human waste. So, impurities in water refers to the substance or particles that are present in water and can affect its quality. Example impurities in water include dust, dirt, harmful chemicals, biological contaminants, radiological contaminants, and total suspended solid or TSS. Then yung mga topic niya is entrained gases. Entrained gases are carbon dioxide, hydrogen, sulfide, methane, oxygen, and nitrogen and organic compounds. Example niya is entrained gases include dissolved oxygen, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrogen, and hydrogen sulfide. These gases can have important implications for water quality, aquatic ecosystem, and human health. Next is dissolved minerals. Dissolved minerals are calcium, magnesium, sodium, iron, and manganese, and other carbonates and silicates. Alkali, basin, sulfate from the detergent and synthetic organic insecticide and pesticide. Example dissolved minerals in water include calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium, and bicarbonates. These minerals can affect the taste, hardness, and overall quality of the water. Next is suspended and colloidal materials such as bacteria, algae, fungi, silt, protozoa, and other. Example niya is suspended materials include sand, silt, clay, organic matter. On the other hand, colloidal materials in water refers to particles that are intermediate in size between dissolved substance and suspended materials. Example niya is colloidal materials include fine clay, particles, bacteria, viruses, and proteins. Next is radioactive. By entrainment of radioactive substance for mining or processing ores by waste from industrial use of radioactive materials. For example of radioactive impurity in water is radon. A natural occurring radioactive gas that can dissolve in groundwater, radon is a byproduct of the decay of uranium and can pose health risks in present high concentration in drinking water. Next is the lead. Lead is a pipe should not be used for distribution of soft acid water or for water having a high concentration of dissolved oxygen or chlorides. The solution of lead and water with such characteristic may cause lead poisoning. Lead poisoning as medical condition caused by increased levels of lead of the body. Most commonly from exposure to lead-based paints in other buildings. In any source of public water supply, the following conditions shall be strictly observed to avoid the possibility of contaminations. So first is wells that are supplying water for public use should be located at minimum distance of 100 meters radius from residential areas. Second is all residents within these zones limit shall be strictly required to have sanitary sewage facilities. Third is there should be no concrete sanitary sewers existing within the 15 meters radius of the well. Fourth is no outdoor private cesspool, septic tank, or drain field shall be located within 45 meters radius from the well. Fifth, the area shall be well drained to divert surface water from the well and minimize the possibility of flooding. Sixth, all abandoned wells near the site chosen for the new well should be plugged and properly sealed to prevent possible contaminations of the ground formations. To prevent contaminations in public water supplies, the following measure should be followed. Well supplying water for public use should be located at least 100 meters away from residential areas. Residents in this zone should have sanitary sewage facility concretes. Sanitary sewers should be not exist within 15 meters of the well. No outer privy or safety tank should be within 45 meters of the well. The area should be well drained to divert surface water and abandoned well nearby should be properly sealed to prevent groundwater contaminations. Next is what is spring water? Spring water is nothing more than very shallow well with water, taken from a water stratum composed of cervical limestones, sand, or gravel lying few meters below the earth. Contrary to the common belief, spring water is not always from free contaminations. Indeed, it is uncertain to conclude that spring water is protected from surface water contaminations by impervious formations of the soil. Therefore, extreme precautions should be exercised in developing water intended for drinking and household use. For example, of spring water is a type of water that naturally flows to the surface from an underground source, such as aquifer. It is typically known for its purity and may be collected directly from spring for drinking or commercial purposes. Water for drinking and household purposes should be protected from First is surface or runoff water. Second is dust. Third is insect. Fourth is wildlife. And lastly is stock. The fish wherein the spring water will flow should be enclosed completely with a reservoir of concrete, tile, steel, or other impervious materials under the following considerations. First is the depth. The deep of the reservoir wall shall be penetrate downward the impervious formations beneath the water, producing stratum. Second is the reservoir cover shall be insect type roof, free from the dust and rain water. A manhole of the raised curving type with the overlapping cover on the edges terminating in the downward direction shall be provided with the facility for locking. Fourth is the reservoir should be disinfected with the chlorine solutions and the flush truly prior to the submitting of sample for the laboratory test. Water from the spring reservoir shall be declared safe only after the result of bacteriological tests. Next is the different types of individual wellspring. First is dug wells. A dug well is a type of well that is excavated by the hand tools or power machinery rather than being drilled or driven. These wells are typically shallow and a large diameter and they were commonly constructed before World War II. Second is bored wells. A bored well refers to the well that is excavated using an earth auger and is typically smaller in diameter compared to drilled wells. Bored wells are designed to access low yield and shallow aquifers while ensuring bacteriological safety through the use of casing, collars, concrete slabs, and other specifications. Example of bored wells include those with a deep ranging from 30 to 80 feet, varying specifications regarding the depth of casing or collar concrete slabs or covers of proximity to potential source of pollution. Third is driven wells. Driven wells refers to wells that are constructed by driving a pipe or casing into ground without the use of drilling or boring device. They are typically used in sandy and unconsolidated ground conditions and are relatively easy and inexpensive to install. Fourth is drilled wells. A drilled well is a type of well that is created by boring or drilling a hole into the ground using a drill rig. It typically involves the use of casing to the line well and prevent contaminations. Example is drilled wells include water wells for the domestic use, agricultural irrigations, or industrial purposes. I hope this video gain informations about the chapter 13 under my subtopics. Thank you.